traders, Trader Mike here with you. Friday, about to start the weekend. Just gonna go over a review of the markets. Just gonna go over a daily video today. Just give you a daily one. We'll get a weekend video out for you by the end of the weekend, and I'm gonna have the watch list up on the site this week. Great watch list, made a ton of money there. Let's hopefully we can turn it around and do it again. So right now I'm just gonna pull up the SPY and we'll take a look at what happened today on the SPY. All right, here we go. All right, here's the 5-minute chart of the SPY. Starting off in the morning, notice all these trend lines I have in here. Some of them I did draw today. Actually, I only drew two in today, and the rest of them were actually in here on the 5-minute chart from yesterday. So if you look over here at the open at 9:30, after we had the GDP numbers, we came up and rallied, but we rallied right into the area of the close yesterday, and we did close above. And sure enough, we had this engulfing candle, engulfed that whole candle, and sold off right down to this prior level, which we had drawn in here yesterday. Now, as I go back to yesterday and show you, this is the level that we had in yesterday, and it was right around the opening level of yesterday that we sold back down to here today and caught some support. Now, we rallied and caught the same exact level yet again on the next rally, and we came back and found this support from support yesterday. Now, when you look back here at the chart where these support levels are drawn from the day before, and these support and resistance levels are holding today's action. Now, that means you got some pretty good levels here on the chart, and pretty much you can, if you're scalping the market, you want to take a scalp at these levels of the prior day. And if you were to take a scalp here and up here, it would have worked out pretty good. Now, as we came down and started trading back down into the support level, we started making a new trend line in here, so I drew this trend line in, and as the day went on, I was looking for a breakout. We got a breakout of this trend line, came up and consolidated at resistance, consolidated again at resistance, broke out, and just look how these levels do hold here in the market. These levels are holding to a T. We came up to make new highs, so I drew a little mark at the highs. As we sold back down and caught support at this 50, we came up and rallied right into these highs here towards the end of the day, and we actually couldn't hold that level and just sold off one more time. So these trend lines that I am drawing in the market are holding up pretty well. Now I'm going to bring up the daily chart for you, and I'm going to show you a little bit of the action on the daily chart. Hold on, let me just get my video screen up here, and then I'll pull up the daily and we'll go over the Dow and the NASDAQ. Alright, so with today's action, we had the Dow up 17, the NASDAQ down 6, the S&P up almost 1, and the VIX up 0.5 points. Taking a look at the daily chart yet again, we are catching some support here at this 0% retracement from the move from the highs up here when I drew this retracement in before. So we're taking a look right over here at the highs over here. We're catching some support. In the last 2 days, we had two dojis right here in the last 2 days, and it is showing me that there is some sign that we might be moving lower here in the markets. Now, as I was looking for before, I just left this retracement as before. I was looking for actually some kind of pullback, possibly not this 96 level. And if we don't get the 96 level, I'm looking for something around 1,007 here on the S&P for right now. If we do hit 1,007, we're going to have to go back and look at the charts. I believe we do have a possibility of moving up to around 1050, 1060 area as we do close in on 1,007. If that does happen, I'll go back and evaluate and see where exactly we're going to go. But I do like that what's sort of happening here is we're just sort of kind of happening to making some lower lows and lower highs. And if we do have the possibility of coming in here and consolidating on this trend line I just drew in between the highs and filling this gap, we might actually catch some support at the gap right around this 98 level. And once we get down here and consolidate down to this 98 level, we might get a pop through this trend line, and it might bring us a little higher. Now, the volume in the market today, it was some decent volume in the market, but I would have liked to see more volume here with the GDP numbers. It could be because it was a Friday. It could be for a couple different factors, but you know what? I'd like to see a little more volume here. But basically, we're just standing still. Some news on Elon in the after hours that's pushing our trade up a little higher here. Other than that, on Sunday, I'm going to get you a weekend edition. Check out the longer-term charts and the watch list. Come check us out, www.ms100.com.